It was the afternoon show kids across the country absolutely loved. Simon Townsend, his trusty sidekick Woodrow, and a team of reporters showed us every day that the world truly is a wonderful place. But since the glory days of the 80s, Simon has faced some pretty terrible struggles. He sat down with our very own Craig Bennett for this exclusive interview.
Simon Townsend's Wonder World was the first of its kind.
What's this gadget here?
Ah, solar art. That was my...
Every weekday afternoon at 4, this innovative news and current affairs program captured the imagination of Aussie kids who believed the world really was wonderful. When you're part of a beautiful world. As Simon catches up with his intrepid reporters, we talk candidly about the show, his world, and how it all ultimately came crashing down.
Five strokes have left me with slow walk and slow talk. That's why I don't speak well.
Simon became a media sensation, and with all that huge success and plenty of money rolling in, he considered himself a very lucky man.
Unbelievably lucky. When Wonderworld started off, I had a little boy, a toddler, and a newborn baby girl. So my kids grew up for 8 years. Their childhood was spent with my show. It was wonderful to be a father and to have two kids and to be working in children's television. So those were wonderful years. I also made a lot of money, and that was the 80s, most unbelievable time in Australian history.
You were rich, weren't you?
There
were beautiful
rich
cars and boats, and I've been to your fabulous houses all over the state.
I love that time. Then it all comes to an end.
You did hit some hard times, didn't you?
Very hard times.
What happened? Why did those hard times come?
Even before TV and even before money, I was a very successful property investor. I was a good landlord. I had these little two-bedroom flats, four of them, around Sydney, and making a little bit of money on the side. And then I, after Wonderworld, I had a tremendous borrowing capacity because I built up this portfolio of businesses.
You had millions, you did.
But then 1990 crash happened, and suddenly the banks called up all my loans and...
The bottom fell out of your world.
The bottom fell out of my world.
I think probably one of the great sadnesses was the loss of your wonderful wife, Rosanna, who really was your rock, wasn't she?
She was. She's my partner in life and partner in business.
27 years?
27 years married, and she died from lung cancer about 30 years ago. It's very sad.
Simon had two kids with second wife, Rosanna. There's businessman Michael and Nadia, an esteemed actress. Almost 50 years ago, Simon had a daughter, Lisbeth, out of wedlock, who was put up for adoption. Decades later, there was a very emotional reunion.
How do you rally from that? Because two beautiful kids, and well, three really, when you think that you're reunited with your daughter, Lisbeth, who was adopted out.
Well, and like everybody has to, you just go on with life.
People would have seen your life though, you know, life really is wonderful, and maybe not realised that you'd gone through that kind of ordeal. And then the strokes.
This is why I don't speak well. Because five strokes have left me with slow walk and slow talk. But, you know, life goes on. I have reached 70, which is not bad. Didn't think I'd reach 70.
You didn't, did you?
No.
You didn't think you'd make 70?
No. Come on, skinny love,
just last the year. Knowing you as I have, Simon, and I hope you don't mind me sharing this, but a beautiful story you told me was with regard to your personal life, and in more recent times you met up with your very first love, Kerry Gleeson.
Yeah, about 7 years after Rosanna had died, I met up with my first girlfriend from Woi Woi. We were both age 17, her name was Carrie, and we met up on the internet and started a romance again. And I shared her last 7 years. She died a year ago.
That, I have to say, was such a shock.
Mm.
For all of those who knew you and Carrie, and we'd spent time together, a beautiful, amazing woman who, in tough times for you, brought such joy to your life again, didn't she? And to go, she just dropped dead, didn't she?
A heart attack.
Makes no sense, does it? Terrible. But you're a doting granddad.
I am. I love my four grandkids.
And they bring light to your life, don't they?
They do indeed. I love them.
And now for all the intellectuals in the audience, tell me about your famous giggle, Simon. To this day... No, to this day, everyone loves it. I mean, you just don't do that on Current Affairs television. Was it a weird liberation for you to have that little giggle on?
Well, I really enjoyed sitting there in the studio, and I would be so enjoying myself. It was easy to laugh. I had Woodrow sitting next to me, and he would do weird things. He'd try to grab things out of my hand. And
dribbling all the time.
And, yeah, drooling.
Falling asleep.
Falling asleep. So, enjoying myself so much, it was easy to laugh. Never things to laugh at. After Woodrow died, I replaced him with a little Labrador. He was not pretty much appreciated. And this bloody cockatoo that flew away from me up into the rafters in the studio.
Who had to get Winston down from the lighting?
And they'd give up, and I'd come back the next day and he'd still be up in the I had no idea, I was so naive, I had no idea that the song Afternoon Delight was about having sex in the afternoon. When someone said, in about the sixth week of my show, do you know what that song's about? And I said, no. An afternoon delight. It's about having sex in the afternoon. I'm not caught. So I immediately ordered to strap it, and I commissioned someone to write a new Wonderworld theme.
With the great John St. Peter singing
it. Yeah.
And that became the anthem.
Welcome to my Wonderworld.
For Simon, it was an emotional reunion with his former reporters, but was it enough to entice him back to television?
It's the world we live in.
Being here with my former colleagues and listening to them talk, I get excited and think, gosh, I miss TV. But I'm 70 years old, I'm not in the best of health, so I wouldn't want to really take it on again. But I enjoy watching it.
With all that you've been through, Simon, over the years, the highs, the lows, the heartache, is the world still really wonderful?
I promise you, I still believe that the world really is wonderful.
Been through everything. They just threw everything at him, didn't they?
He was such a larger-than-life character. He used to come and see me when I was running the Women's Weekly. We had a Wonder World page for the children in the magazine. When he'd come, you know, we would come in to chat, and he was full of ideas. You know, he'd have this idea and that idea and this idea. He was impossible not to like. He was just, and he still is. He's a terrific guy.
And the show was so huge as well. Yeah. Like instantly, as soon as you hear the theme song, you can know every word. I used to have the Wonder World sort of almanac kind of thing, and it had Simon Townsend and Woodrow facing out on the front, and then when you turned over on the back, it had their backs, the back of the thing.
What about Jono?
How did they do that?
Yeah, Jono
was
too.
Jono was the centrefold.
Is it true, Jess, you were saying that our wonderful studio cameraman, Herman, who's behind this camera here, used to look after Woodrow?
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Did you?
He was in charge of,
There you
go?
Were there any particular...
Yeah, actually, how long were we looking after him for? What happened?
And Winston as well.
Oh, did you have to get Winston from the rafters?
Yep. Oh. He used to fly away all the time.
Oh.
And did you look after any animals that survived him?
Just me.
We're all looking after Jono.
He's hoping that you'll fly away one day. what an incredible story from Craig Bennett. The last two have been brilliant. It's a nice way to reminisce in the morning, isn't it?
That's a lovely story.